at FourBearsCasino.com, The Players Club, and 800-294-5454.
Ladies, welcome to my digestive system. When your gut and vaginal bacteria are off balance, you may feel it.
But just one Align Women's Probiotic Daily helps soothe digestive upsets and support vaginal health. Welcome to an Align Gut.
It's nothing.
Sounds like something.
When you have nausea, heartburn, indigestion, upset stomach, diarrhea.
Pepto-Bismol coats and soothes for fast relief when you need it most.
I'm Corporal Klinger.
That must be me, sir.
I tried everything to get out of the Army.
I'll do anything to prove I'm not fit.
I sailed on a raft. I ate a Jeep.
Dip it in a little 30-weight motor oil, pop it in, and let it slide down the gullet.
But I never got out, which means you can watch more of me on MeTV.
Warm weather months make our great state come alive. As we head outside to play,
you'll want to check here first to make sure Mother Nature is on board with your plans today.
And into the weekend. Let's go, Larks!
And no matter what crazy weather comes our way, you'll find us in the First Warn Forecast Center when things turn severe. Your First Warn weather team is with you minute by minute all summer long. Keep counting on KFYR, your news and weather leader.
Coming up tomorrow, it's the 4th of July party.
The Grill Dad stopped by to get our holiday cookout started right.
Plus, Preston Conrad will show us the latest in summer home decor.
And the Ohio couple making a difference in the lives of veterans.
We'll see you guys tomorrow.
Bye, y'all.
Bye.
But it'll never be the same.
It's ninja versus ninja.
Rising up into bounds.
For the first time ever, ninjas will race side by side.
This is ninja but turbocharged.
We're playing fucking playing hard.
Here we go.
Lay it all on the line. Can't go shine. This is my time.
It's gonna be close.
Yes, we're having a party and it lasts all summer long, and you're invited.
Every day, a brand new show.
We're dishing on the hottest topics. We're hanging out with some of our favorite friends.
What surprises you're going to love.
It's all this summer on Hoda and Jenna.
At Zimmerman's, here's what we say. We got low prices every day. Zimmerman's furniture gives you more of what you're looking for. Zimmerman's furniture.
Welcome to Pearson's Green Acre Meats. Our Angus beef are born, raised, and processed right on site with no antibiotics and growth hormones. Located 8.5 miles east of Wilton, North Dakota, just off Highway 36. Stop in or call today to get your desired cut of beef or try some turkey, honey barbecue bites, summer sausage, country style, and breakfast sausage. We also have openings for custom slaughtering, too. Pearson's Green Acre Meats, 701-734-6670.
When thunder roars, go indoors. We are still getting reports of hail.
A couple of thunderstorms still a possibility right now in the Williston area.
Curb to curb flooding, winds over 30 miles per hour, and a lot of hail.
Your First Warn weather team is always keeping you one step ahead of the storm. Keep following KFYR-TV, your news and weather leader.
Coming up on First News at noon, there have been 3 reports of house fires in the area since yesterday morning. More on that in a moment.
I'm tracking scattered showers and storms and an update on your severe weather potential coming up.
And later, a wildfire in Washington State has burned structures and it continues to be a problem.
First News at noon starts right now.
Good afternoon. I'm Wade Wolf in for Krista Kudrowski. We thank you so much for joining us. An unattended cooking fire at a Southwest Minot apartment early this morning sent one person to the hospital for smoke inhalation. Austin Burns with Minot Fire says that they received the call shortly after 2 o'clock this morning at the Chateau Apartments. Crews from all four stations responded. Burns says crews located the fire in a second floor unit, and they were able to limit the damage to one unit, but the apartment was evacuated during the response. The status of the person sent to the hospital is not clear. The Bismarck Fire Department responded to a mobile home fire a little after midnight this morning. That fire was reported in the 2500 block of Centennial Drive. That's where firefighters found fire and heavy smoke on the deck and front entry. All residents of the home were evacuated, but one pet had to be pulled from the fire. It received medical care from the firefighters as well as a veterinarian. Firefighters were able to put the fire out in about 15 minutes. The cause of that fire is still under investigation. And Jacob, how many people are getting ready to get a jump on the Independence Day holiday and finding some rain showers up and around their area?
There are some areas dealing with some light to moderate rain, even a few rumbles of thunder. But good news to pass along to you regarding our severe weather threat later this afternoon and evening. It has been downgraded to only a level one risk for far southern North Dakota. The higher potential for seeing severe storms has been pushed down to the south, the Black Hills, under the gun for numerous severe storms in portions of western South Dakota. There is still that chance for seeing one or two isolated strong severe storms later this afternoon and evening. But looking at SkyTracker radar right now, scattering of showers and storms with a few lightning strikes near Henninger, a couple other light to moderate showers just to the south of Beach, light rain around the Linton and Napoleon areas south and east of Bismarck, and a steady stream of showers and storms moving between Williston, Stanley, and Minot. On our Williston Skywatch cam, we can see a few of those raindrops on the camera lens. The wet streets, temperature at 55 degrees, so certainly a cooler day compared to yesterday with our widespread cloudiness as well. Temperatures will struggle to reach the 70 degree mark in many locations throughout your afternoon hours, with a few more of those scattered showers and storms. We'll go hour by hour with that forecast for the rest of your day coming up a little bit later on, Wayne.
You know, I was outside a while ago, Jacob. It's still pretty muggy out there, even though the temperature's cooler.
Yeah, dew points are still a little bit elevated as that cold front sliding through.
All right, we'll have more with you in a moment. Thanks, Jacob. A Bismarck couple spent their 52nd wedding anniversary cleaning up from a fire that destroyed their home on Sunday morning. Mary Wagner says her husband's oxygen tank exploded just before 10:30 on Sunday morning. That started a fire in their home on Northwest Drive in the Airport Village Mobile Home Park. The Wagners were both able to get safely out of the home, but crews battled heavy smoke and fire for about 15 minutes. Firefighters rescued a kitten from the home. They gave Pepper oxygen, but Mary says the kitten is doing fine now. Family members spent much of the day taking items out of the home and saving what they could. The Wagners have lived in that home for 51 years. Mary's daughter says while she knows it's just stuff, that stuff holds some precious memories.
This is my childhood. This is where all my birthday parties were. This is where all my sleepovers as a kid were. Christmases, holidays, all here.
The Wagners were both taken to the hospital, but both were treated and released. Their home is a total loss. A South Hard woman charged with threatening Governor Doug Burgum will go through a psychological evaluation to see if she is fit for trial. Court documents say 46-year-old Jody Kuntz made several phone calls this year saying the governor would, quote, meet his demise. Her lawyer made the request for an evaluation, saying Kuntz has a history of psychiatric conditions as well as treatment. She could serve just less than a year in jail and a fine of up to $3,000 if she's found guilty of harassment. The Dawson County Sheriff's Office is asking for help looking for a missing woman. Renee Arcand was last seen on Tuesday, June 27th, camping at Fish Intake near Glendive. She's 36 years old, about 5'6", and weighs around 150 pounds. She has brown hair and hazel eyes. She has a heart and vine tattoo on her leg and a "this too shall pass" quote on her wrist. If you have any information on her whereabouts, contact the Dawson County Sheriff's Office at 406-377-5291. Being able to connect to the internet has become essential to everyday life. In rural parts of the country, access is difficult. Some federal grants are aimed at improving availability. The U.S. Department of Commerce announced billions of dollars from the Bipartisan Infrastructure Act that would be used to help providers expand services. The Commerce Secretary says the Broadband Equity Access and Deployment Program would bring internet access to many across the country.
We will provide funding for them to lay fiber in places that are expensive, you know, in rural America, in mountainous America. But we expect them to then provide the internet high quality, low cost for every American.
Through the program, North Dakota will get more than $130 million, while Montana will receive more than $628 million to cover more than 100,000 locations across the state. Verizon phone users may have noticed an upgrade to their services. The company announced their 5G ultra-wideband network has been expanded to North Dakota. A release from Verizon says the service allows phones to run at speeds comparable to home internet. Some of the towns mentioned were Williston, Velva, Jamestown, and Center. There's a place that springs to mind where pale pink prairie roses bloom, where summer crops and kids grow up beneath skies of hopeful blue. That catchy tune is the new North Dakota state anthem. North Dakota natives and lifelong friends Kyle Gagner and Josh Silbernagel wrote the song in 2021. They were in a band together as teenagers, and this project brought them back together. They wrote the song and then sent it to some friends in Nashville to record. They then turned it over to the North Dakota Tourism Department to run with. The result is this music video. Josh says listening to it never gets old, and each time he hears this song, he's proud to be a North Dakotan.
I love the land. I love the people. It's just a special place, and whatever your political stripe or ideological leanings, hopefully this song is something that, you know, a North Dakotan or someone with a history here can identify with and feel positive about.
You can listen to the anthem on the North Dakota Tourism YouTube page. We'll also have one of the writers and the song on tomorrow's North Dakota Today program that starts at 9 o'clock Central. You can also search for it under North Dakota Anthem. On a hot summer day, there's nothing better than a trip to the swimming pool. But many small towns in North and South Dakota no longer have public pools. So often, a trip to the pool means a drive of an hour or more. And for many in northern South Dakota, that drive takes them to the Mobridge Aquatic Center. That pool features two diving boards and a giant water slide. City officials say they're happy to share their state-of-the-art facility with neighboring communities.
We have the facility, we have the employees, we have the vicinity around us where they can come and they can enjoy their summer. They can be safe. We teach kids how to do swim lessons.
Lifeguards at the Mobridge Aquatic Center will teach four sessions of swimming lessons this summer. As many as 80 kids are expected at each of those sessions. That includes kids from Mobridge as well as from nearby communities. The nationwide lifeguard shortage has forced many public pools to reduce their hours or not open at all this summer. But the Mobridge Aquatic Center is fully staffed. Nearly two dozen teens are working at the pool this summer. And there's a list of more that want jobs there as well. Up next on First News at Noon, after several days of protests in Paris, a rally in support of one of the victims of the violence. We'll have that story after the break.
You're watching KFYR First News at Noon.
Serenity Health in North Mandan is not just a family practice, it's your whole family's practice.
Needing to get your kids back on track? Schedule your sports physical today. Serenity Health, for all your physical needs.
Call us today. See us today.
Doing business with Window Source has really improved my life. My wife doesn't worry when I mow the lawn anymore.
It's okay, dear. We have Window Source.
Hi, I'm Jesse with the Window Source. Give us a call today.
3B or not 3B? There is no question.
Baby back ribs, great for the smoker. 3B meats, cut so good, it's poetic.
May
making each moment matter. Through care and compassion. For you. For them. For us. Hospice of the Red River Valley.
It's the granddaddy of all IMCA modified tours. The 34th annual Dakota Classic modified tour presented by Tri-Energy Senex comes to the Dakota Speedway Thursday, July 13th. Tickets are $20 and kids 12 and under are free. Don't miss a second of the best racing action in the Midwest.
Get 11% off everything now at Menards. Easily take on outdoor projects with Yardworks. Save on everything you need for maintaining your yard. Get this 100-foot contractor-grade garden hose for only $59.99 after rebate. Whether it's removing deep-seated stains or washing down a vehicle, Masterforce pressure washers have the power you need for making short work with any job. Pick up a Masterforce electric pressure washer for $355.99 after 11% rebate.
Save big money at Menards.
You're watching KFYR First News at Noon.
The Israeli military used drones to attack areas in the West Bank city of Jenin today, where at least 8 deaths have been reported. Hundreds of troops were also deployed in the Jenin refuge camp in what's the largest operation in the area during more than a year of fighting. Palestinian and Jordanian officials have condemned the attacks. More than 24 others were also injured in the strikes. An Israeli army spokesperson says the operation began on a building believed to be used by militants to plan those attacks. Several hundred supporters turned out in a march of solidarity today for the Paris suburb mayor whose house was attacked early yesterday. France has been rocked by violent riots following the deadly shooting of a teenager in another suburb last week. The march took place after the mayor's house was attacked by a burning car early Sunday morning. The mayor's wife was injured, as well as one of his children. He called it an assassination attempt. There's another standoff which could create havoc with the entertainment industry for at least the next few months. About 15,000 employees at 65 major hotels in the Los Angeles area walked off the job Sunday, and they're on strike. The union representing the workers says they've been in talks since April over issues, including an immediate $5 per hour raise and better health care and retirement benefits. Plans for thousands of actors to join the picket line against studios and streaming services are now on hold until July 12th. A fast-growing fire burning in Washington state is threatening structures and causing hundreds of residents to evacuate. The fire had grown to nearly 315 acres by Sunday night, and it's threatening about 100 structures. Fire officials say it's unclear how many buildings have been lost. Evacuees with horses and dogs found refuge on Sunday night at an evacuee center. Now let's find out a little bit more about our Independence Day forecast.
Yeah, our fireworks forecast for July 4th tomorrow evening shaping up to be a cool one with temperatures falling back from the 60s into the 50s. More details coming up.
Tired of mealtime meh? Give your appetite a vacation at Taco John's. A trip to crispy shrimp taco paradise with freshly made mango salsa does wonders. Ooh, I think I'm getting a tan. 3 for $6 mango shrimp street tacos. Summertime only at Taco John's.
I really ruined everything. I should have done something sooner.
Everybody hopes that this won't be a big problem. Unfortunately, basement water, it always gets worse. Don't worry, we got this.
Great. Well, let's stop it from getting in.
The effects of water can be surprising, but at Innovative Basement Authority, we'll do a complete home inspection for free, so you can put water back in its place. Schedule a free home inspection today.
Love it or hate it, you can't deny that North Dakota weather is exciting and interesting. And as a meteorologist, I find it especially fascinating. Every Wednesday on First News at 4, I answer your burning weather questions like,
what makes our sunset so colorful? Ooh, what makes snowflakes different shapes?
How do the northern lights form?
Well, I'll tell you. Tune in this Wednesday as I, Jacob Morse, decode another weather wonder with the Morse Code of Weather on your news leader.
Some things can't be taught. A nose for news, the ability to tell a story using pictures as well as words, the desire to be first on the scene of any event. KFYR-TV has an immediate opening for a multimedia journalist to round out our experienced news team. It helps to know your way around a video camera and editing software, but if you recognize yourself in the above description, we will consider training you. Salary is competitive. Contact News Director J.R. Havens for more information about joining our team.
If money talked, it would tell you about the premium ingredients on Taco John's Valueist menu starting at $1, $2, or $3. Hand-cut sirloin steak, crispy fried chicken, and fresh pico. And if your appetite talked, it would say cha-ching. The Valueist menu, only at Taco John's.
At Zimmerman's, we'll help you decorate any room in your home and we'll make it as comfortable and beautiful as possible. Come see us at Zimmerman's.
A wide range in temperatures across our region with a cloud cover, and the rain showers have been a bit more persistent near Williston. Temperatures still in the 50s, but we're up to 73 degrees in the capital city right now. A good deal of cloud cover region-wide, though, with this system moving through, producing sustained winds between 5 and 20 miles per hour. The dew points that Wayne mentioned earlier, a little bit elevated still into the 50s in some locations, but with this cold front passing through, those dew points will be decreasing along with our temperatures. So highs today in the 70s, tomorrow we'll only see highs in the 60s for many locations. But for precipitation chances, city by city, we're drying up in Williston over the next couple of hours throughout your afternoon hours. Similar situation in Minot, but across the south, we'll stick with those precipitation chances, and there might be an increase in seeing a shower or a storm into your overnight hours tonight. You can really see that potential for the Bismarck-Mandan area. After sunset, we'll see a complex of showers and storms likely move through the southern portion of the state. So let's go hour by hour here. This first batch of mostly showers, there's not a whole lot of lightning activity in the Peace Garden State right now. We'll continue to progress eastward, clearing out by about 5 or 6 o'clock. So we'll have a break in the action this evening before that level one risk in this green shaded area will be present for strong to severe storms this evening and tonight, as we'll see a few of these complexes of storms come up from South Dakota and over towards Montana. Moving into our areas, a 1 a.m. snapshot tonight with those showers and storms along and south of the interstate. And then your all-important July 4th forecast tomorrow, we will see a bit more sunshine with winds out of the northwest and an isolated pop-up shower or a storm later in the afternoon or evening towards south central or southeastern North Dakota, although most areas will be staying dry. 50s for the overnight hours tonight, and then tomorrow, as I mentioned, 60s for highs for many locations. This will be the coolest July 4th since 2004 or 2005 across the region. Got to go back that many years to get temperatures in the 60s and 70s, so certainly below normal temperatures. And one thing I haven't mentioned a lot about July 4th this year will be that those winds will be a bit breezy out of the northwest, so that might impact some firework plans into your evening hours, as they will diminish though after sunset. Some gust by the evening could top out at 25 miles per hour tomorrow with those showers and storms clearing out. So most of the daytime hours on your Tuesday, July 4th, will be dry. Just that isolated pop-up potential later in the day, odds at about 20%. Coolest day of the week, Wednesday, when most areas will be in the 60s. Some areas might touch on 70 degrees right on that mark, but overnight lows likely will be in the 40s for the middle portion of the week, Wayne, before temperatures start to rebound by the end of the week, and we do see a couple of isolated shower and storm chances enter the forecast by Friday and next weekend.
All right, thank you, Jacob. You know, it's going to be one of the cooler ones we've had in a while, so if you like that kind of weather, it's time to enjoy it.
Yep, refreshing for some, yep. But if you want the summer-like heat and humidity, This past weekend was for you.
Sounds good. Thanks, Jacob.
You're welcome.
Coming up later on First News at 4, while a lot of people head to the beach in the summertime, some diehard skiers are still hitting the slopes. We'll tell you where they're still finding snowy mountains later today at 4. And we'll be right back with more First News at Noon in a moment.
It's the Star Spangled 4th of July sale at Denver Mattress. Right now, save $100 on every $1,000 you spend. Or check out the Summit for only $299.99. Plus 6 years no interest and free shipping. But hurry, the Star Spangled 4th of July sale at Denver Mattress ends soon.
We all need fiber for our digestive health, but less than 10% of us get enough each day. Good thing Metamucil gummies are an easy way to get prebiotic plant-based fiber with the same amount of fiber as 2 cups of broccoli. Metamucil gummies, the easy way to get your daily fiber.
When you really need to sleep, you reach for the really good stuff. ZzzQuil Ultra helps you sleep better and longer when you need it most. It's non-habit forming and powered by the makers of NyQuil. ZzzQuil Ultra, when you really, really need to sleep.
The all-new Emergency Trauma Center.
built with your reassurance in mind. The new healthcare campus and medical district, now open in Minot. Trinity Health, making more possible. An entire floor dedicated to women and children's health, built with your family in mind. The new healthcare campus and medical district, now open in Minot. Trinity Health, making more possible.
Buy your next vehicle direct today at GeraldWetzel.com. New inventory arriving weekly. Cars, trucks, SUVs, and vans. See our entire inventory at GeraldWetzel.com or at 1030 South 22nd Street, Bismarck.
Journey to 50 new and exciting destinations in North and South Dakota and Eastern Montana. With Cliff Naylor's new Dakota Day Trips book, The Road to Rural Wonders is the latest edition of Cliff's popular travel series based on his off-the-beaten-path television stories. Get your copy today and start exploring lots of unique and interesting local sites. Send a check for $15 to KFYR-TV, 200 North 4th Street, Bismarck, North Dakota, 58501.
A memorial service was held over the weekend for a Strasburg World War II veteran whose details of death have been a mystery for many years.
It's very meaningful.
Very meaningful, yeah.
To finally have the story.
Yes.
And to recognize Ralph.
Right.
And send him off right like he should have been.
Right.
And we haven't forgotten him.
According to Navy records, the sinking of the Rana is considered the greatest loss of U.S. life at sea. Four other North Dakotans were among the 1,015 troops that were killed that day. Private Ralph Sitter was a member of the U.S. Army Air Force's 853rd Engineer Battalion when the boat was stationed on the HMT Rana. It was bombed in 1943. To Sitter's family, he died at sea with very few details until a Google search by his niece in 2021 revealed the truth. The service featured a placing of a replica grave marker and presentation of the U.S. flag by the North Dakota National Guard. The 4th of July is a joyous holiday for many. But with the light shows, some people can be affected by the loud noises and those lights. Ralph Olczewski wants to let his fellow veterans know if they're dealing with PTSD around the holiday, there are resources to help them. He believes the 4th of July can be triggering for many veterans. He says Bismarck Vet Center has a great atmosphere to help veterans feel supported.
When I got home in Vietnam, that was back in the 70s, I went through a lot of hard times, and the VA, I didn't really think they could help. But in the last 80s, when I needed more help, then finally the VA, I think they're doing an outstanding job now. We just need to get the veterans connected.
On August 24th, there will be an event, Veteran Stand Down at AmVets, and he encourages all veterans to attend. There will be 30 to 40 vendors, food, and lots of assistance to get veterans connected with resources. And we'll be right back with more First News at Noon after this.
Healthy Systems USA Black Friday in July sale. Two-month program, one-month price. It's like getting 1 month for free. Buy it for yourself or split it with a friend. Lose up to 1 pound of fat a day.
If you've got that, don't worry about that. Healthy Systems USA.
Welcome back to AGR. Five Star Roofing just finished reshingling this home. Let's hear from our judges.
The way you handled that hammer, phenomenal. You guys are going places.
I am absolutely speechless. I loved everything you guys did, and you got it done great.
I just find it appalling how much I love those shingles. It's five for me.
Five Star Roofing, our name says it all.
Who would you trust to service your car?
Gunters. Gunters. If you want a free estimate
or a second opinion,
call Gunters Auto Repair today.
Some lines are worth the wait. At the end of this one is a fresh baked this morning treat like nothing else in town. Brick Oven Bakery, the line is worth your time. We'll see you at the bakery.
All right, have a nice day.
Have a question, she'll give you advice. It's no trouble because she's mighty nice, Christine. Big O's Christine. To get a top review online, you need service that's more than just fine, Christine.
It's our Scorchin' Summer Sales Event. Get from $120 to $140 in rebate savings on select tires with installation purchase, plus zero interest if paid in full within 12 or 6 months. Big O Tires, the team you trust.
Get money for a cause in Medora this summer. On July 22nd, lace up for an adventure in the Badlands with 25 obstacles, over 5 miles of mud and challenging terrain, apex monkey bars and swinging rings, to mud crawls and scaling walls. Race it, run it, walk it, or just watch it. Kids, tackle your own challenge at the Half Mile Kids Course. Support Brave the Shave's efforts and go to moneyforacause.com to register. Let's get money for a cause on July 22nd.
Healthy Systems USA Black Friday in July sale. 2 month program, 1 month price. It's like getting 1 month for free. Buy it for yourself or split it with a friend. Lose up to 1 pound of fat a day.
If you've got that, don't worry about that. Healthy Systems USA.
Mr. Food is sponsored by Aero Service Team. Aero Service Team has you covered for any flood, fire, smoke, or water damage emergency.
This time of year, when the summer sun is blazing, I want to remind you that it's important to stay hydrated. It may sound obvious, but so many of us forget to drink that extra glass of water or eat foods that are high in water content. Now, the basic rule of thumb is that you should drink about 8 glasses of water a day, especially if you're outside. And if you're thinking, I can't drink all that water, then make sure you eat lots of fruits and veggies, since they're packed with water. And for a cool way to stay hydrated, how about making some frozen fruit pops? No worries, they're easy. All we do is place chunks of watermelon in a blender or a food processor, along with a bit of water and a little sugar. After it's blended, we pour it into popsicle molds or into paper cups. To take these to another level, we can add some cut up fruit or fresh mint. Once they're frozen, they're ready to enjoy. Get ready for a cool and refreshing treat that'll help you stay hydrated on those hot summer days. To get the recipe for what we call fruity watermelon pops, all you have to do is visit our website. I'm Howard with Kelly in the Mr. Food Test Kitchen, where today we found a cool and refreshing way for you to say, ooh, it's so good.
You know, yesterday, Jacob, that would have been a lot better than what we're looking at tomorrow, because I think some people might even be wearing a jacket around the place.
I know, right? We're going to be cooling off, the heat suppressed down to our south. That's where the sizzling summer-like temperatures will be over the next week, with our cool weather, a bit of a trough in the jet stream lingering over our area. So that means 60s in the forecast for your July 4th. Mix of sun and clouds, only an isolated shower potential later in the day, and by the time the fireworks will be set off, around 10 o'clock, some clouds with temperatures in the 50s and a northwest wind with temperatures throughout most of the week, 60s and 70s, looking a lot cooler below normal temperatures. Wind.
Happy Independence Day, everybody. We'll see you back here on Wednesday. Have a great day.
Save 11% on everything now at Menards. Get the comfort and support you'd expect from a new mattress with Serta. Find the perfect mattress that fits your size and firmness needs. A Serta mattress in a box is compact and easy to transport, making it perfect for students heading back to school. Just unpack and unroll for an easy and convenient setup. Right now, Serta Gel Memory Foam mattresses are starting at $259.99 after rebate.
Save big money at Menards.
This is my favorite part.
Oh, that's my favorite part too. Call the window source today.
Bismarck Farmers Market is open. You never know what you'll find under the tents outside North Ace Hardware. Come early for the most choices. Bismarck Farmers Market, your summer stop for fresh, wholesome food and more.
First Warn Weather Team is always keeping you one step ahead of the storm. Keep following KFYR-TV, your news and weather leader. You're watching KFYR-TV, your news leader.